Hello guys, welcome back, and thank you for joining me for this second chapter of this series where we are doing a head for the Green Goblin. And the theme of this video is going to be references. Right now, since this is of course not the first head I do, I was able to reach or to get up to this point without any reference and doing things from imagination and from my anatomy studies, but I have already detected a couple of flaws. For instance, this mass of fat should not end here, it should continue until the chin, and then there will be a secondary shape that is going to cover the gap left by this mass. And then I will also close the mouth a bit in order to get a loaf, a nice looking and exotic, chaotic, crazy loaf, but with the teeth closed. I don't want to show the interior of the mouth. The teeth will contact bottom and top. I will also probably make the nostrils wider. So, moving forward, unless I need to comment on something in particular, I'll keep on working on the head sculpt. Let's see if this helps, guys. Let's see. There are a couple of reasons why it is important to keep it in stages. First of all, it is not good to focus at one single place at a time. Okay, you should not start tweaking the nose and after 2 hours you realize that the nose is completely off. It's out of proportion, and this lovely nose you have is twice as big as it should be. That's pointless because you are wasting time. You will have to redo all the nice and cute detail. So don't do that. Don't focus too much on a single area until you are way deeper in the project. So another reason to develop the figure in stages, and in particular the stages being the amount of detail that you apply to each area, like major shapes, then secondary shapes, and then fine detail and texture, is because if you want to change a huge area of the face at this point, you are not going to find any obstacle because the detail is not yet done and you won't be thinking, oh, I need to move the chin up, but I will lose all this fine detail I created around the mouth. That's not happening here, and that's an advantage because at this point you want to move everything as freely as possible. You don't want to get obsessed by the work you have done, but the final picture. this time probably to close the mouth a bit. We are going to push from the bottom. I think, and based on the references, that I need to make the chin a little bigger. It is better to put less material than what you need and apply material several times if you feel like you did short, then using more than what it is needed and then be stuck in a position where you don't really know where to move the material to, because you will see that you have enough material ready for the chin, but it is too big, some material is, you need to remove it, and how do you remove it, where do you remove it, because the shape is already there. Do I remove it from the sides, from the front, from where? That's some, I mean, you are always on time to remove material, of course. I'm not gonna say the opposite, but my suggestion is to do this iteratively and do not go all in with a bunch of clay and then you don't know where to move it. Right now I'm going for a kind of a square chin. Shape on the left, not so nice on the right. How do we fix it? First of all, you need to properly assess the volumes, because sometimes you think that the issue is in some point, but it is not there, and the reason is that you did not locate or assess the volume correctly. Volume is not easy to read, it can be quite misleading. It depends on light too, so you should always sculpt with a nice light. See the lower lid, it has these two volumes below, and they do like this shape in the chin. I may use some lenses on the eyes. And in case I use the lenses in the eyes, I need to consider making the area around the eyes skin colored. If that's the case, well, if that is the case, I need to define a bit of volume. Actually, whether I use the skin color or not, I like this volume. Remember, this is a mask, but it could be also skin paint. Side. I'm not sure how to do this. Recon this will be the jawline to the chin will be pointier. So let's compensate for that. As you have seen, I keep on moving from one area to another, fixing issues, fixing flaws that I detect. Okay, so now we are entering the land of the secondary shapes. So what is a secondary shape? Okay, give me a second to fix this. Okay, so what do I consider a secondary shape? So this is a perfect example. We have a basic shape for the eyebrows, right? But now we are going to start making things more appealing. How? Well, you can put that in there. Now we start shaping it. Integrating it into the existing volume. Thank you. And the best way that I can think of defining secondary volumes is that it is a secondary volume if it, this is not a strict rule, okay, but it is a secondary volume if it is not defining the head silhouette. Okay, so as long as it is not defining the silhouette, which is the forehead, the nose, the lips, the chin, the jawline, the eyebrows, the eyes. Okay, so as long as it is not defining the silhouette of the character, that's the secondary shape. Okay, so enough for this second chapter. I think we are leaving it here. Thank you so much for joining me in, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you, bye.